Hi students, welcome to the channel. This video is all about Google App Engine in cloud computing. Okay, so Google App Engine, we can also say it as GAE or simply App Engine. Right, this is an app engine provided by Google. It is a cloud computing platform as a service, right? This is a important term. This is a very important term that Google App Engine is taken through PaaS. That means platform as a service, right? It is used for developing and hosting. Used for developing and hosting web applications in Google managed data centers, right? With the help of Google App Engine, we can access any type of application that are provided by data centers of Google, right? Here some applications are sandboxed and run across multiple servers. That means all the applications that we can run through App Engine can be runboxed and run across multiple servers. We can access or run all the services on different servers according to our system's requirement, right? Here, App Engine offers automatic scaling. It offers automatic scaling for web applications. Scaling here means, in case of cloud computing, every service provided sometimes get lower in scale and sometimes they get higher in scale, right? But in case of App Engine, it offers automatically scaling of web applications. As the number of requests increase for an application, App Engine automatically allocates more resources, right? Automatically scaling means App Engine increases for an application, and App Engine automatically allocates more resources for applications to handle additional demands, right? And as its name implies, App Engine is developed by Google and it is developed on 7 April 2008, right? And it is a type of platform as a service, right? Now we will discuss some primary supports of Google App Engine. The first primary support we have is Go. This is a programming language. Next is PHP, Java, Python. Python is always used in cloud computing. Next is .NET and Ruby. Ruby, right? All these applications are primarily supported by Google App Engine, right? Now, it can also support other languages with custom runtimes. All these services are free up to a certain level. All these services are free up to a certain level of consumed resources and only in standard environment, right? But these are not in a flexible environment. These are not in a flexible environment, right? Some fees are charged for additional storage. In case of Google App Engine, fees are charged for additional storage. For additional storage and or for instance are required by the application. In simple terms, we can say that it also works on the principle of pay per use mode, right? So if we compare Google App Engine with other scalable hosting services such as Amazon EC2 App Engine, right? If we compare Google App Engine with Amazon EC2, App Engine provides more infrastructure. It provides more infrastructure to make it easy to write scalable applications. As we all know, if we have more infrastructure, that means it is easier for us to write more scalable applications, right? But can only run in a limited range of applications designed for that infrastructure, right? Also, App Engine's infrastructure remove many of the system administration and development changes of building applications to scale to hundreds of requests per second and beyond, right? Hundreds or more requests are taken on a per second mode on a Google App Engine. And in case of Amazon EC2, it let the user install and configure every compatible software according to the system's requirement, right? And also App Engine requires developers to use only, it allow developers to use only supported languages and API. API stands for Application Programming Interface. It provide every application an interface for through which it is easier for a customer to access that particular software, right? This is all about Google App Engine in cloud computing. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much for watching this.